Right, now then, here we go. So, we have some questions now, Terry, from the audience, OK, and from our friends out there on Twitter. Now, some of the Twitter questions, Terry, they're frankly, they're beneath you, and, you know, we...
What you're going to ask?
Well, I think I ought to, yes. Who would win in a fight between you and Bruce Forsyth?
Me.
Who's your favourite loose woman?
I'll only say that in my youth, we didn't have enough loose women in our...
Now you can't move without seeing one.
I dare you speak like that about my wife.
Do you have a man bag?
That's something to drain away the vital...
No, no, it's nothing. No, it's not that. Right, audience. Audience, let's move on. We've got Taz. Where is Taz? Hello, Taz.
Hi, Taz.
Thanks for coming along.
Terry, good man yourself.
We haven't won Eurovision for so long. Does everyone hate us?
Yes. You see, Ireland won it 5 times about, and 3 times in succession, because Ireland have never invaded anybody. Britain has invaded and attacked nearly everybody. And it's not that. I addressed the EU on precisely this topic last year, and it became clear to me that the rest of Europe thinks that we think we're far too big for our boots. Mm. That they think, we think, they're beneath us. And of course, they're perfectly right when it comes to, when it comes to popular music. Mm.
Right, we go to Twitter. This is Andy Lysett sent this in. Has Tell, he calls you Tell, a little bit disrespectful.
Yeah, I'm not a football manager.
Has Tell had any problems over the years with headphones? He does have some large ears. You do have very big ears, Terry, I've noticed this.
I do. I don't go out in a high wind, lest I... I take off like Dumbo. But yes, that's a good sign in a man, you know.
Well, look how small mine are.
Yes,
they're,
you see,
they're tiny.
You see, that's another sign.
No moleskin trousers for me.
No.
Let's move on. Anna Crystal. Where's Anna? Hello, Anna. Thank you very much for coming. So Terry Wogan.
Hi, Anna.
Is
it
here.
True Terry Wogan's not your actual name?
No, Michael's my real name. My father's name was Michael as well. He was Michael Thomas.
Yeah.
And my mother couldn't go around the house calling out Michael and both of us standing up at once, so she called me Terry.
So that was so was it Michael Terrence?
Michael Terrence.
Right. Yeah. So you should be Mike Wogan.
I wish it was.
Very good morning to you, ladies and gentlemen. It's Mike Wogan with you.
It's a
just get the travel and the traffic and a time check. Mike Wogan, Beyonce.
It's a better... You're right. It's a better sounding name. I always think Terry is a little bit sort of...
Maya Guermanova. Where's Maya? Where are you, Maya?
Hiya, Maya.
Hiya, Maya, Terry.
Hiya, Maya.
Oh, what's your question for Terry?
Hi. How often do you see the Queen?
I've been very lucky that I've been invited to Buckingham Palace. I've been invited to Windsor Castle to dine with the Queen. And on the last occasion, I happened to notice that she doesn't eat very much. She had a carrot and an onion and a Brussels sprout and a tiny piece of meat. And then she instructed the footman to pour a little gravy over that. And I said, ma'am, you're eating nothing. She turned to me rather sarcastically and said, not like you then.
But it drops off you, doesn't it? I mean, you don't...
Well, although I appear to be calm and very rested, although not this evening, inside I'm a maelstrom of nervous tension.
Coiled spring.
No, if I'd wanted to say coiled spring, I would have said so.
I think it's better than maelstrom sexual tension.
Is
that what you said? We've got time for one more. Claire Butler is here. Where are you, Claire? She's over there. One last question for Terry.
Hello. Have you ever been drunk on air?
There are times during the Eurovision Song Contest when I wished that I'd been drunk on air. When we started the Eurovision Song Contest, I remember the traditional drink was Bailey's Irish Cream with a little ice, because it's a dairy product. And builds strong bones. And so, after about, you know, in the old days, after about song 10, we'd think of pouring ourselves a little libation just to keep our spirits up. And when I did the last one I did, it was after song two. So, no, you can't be drunk on the air, of course. I rely on what remains of me wits to broadcast. So I don't rehearse, I don't prepare, although, obviously, neither do you.
No.
And
ladies and gentlemen, Terry Wogan. Thank you. Thanks as well to the brilliant Hal Cruttenden, and here to play us out, Sharleen Spiteri.